Like Nietzsche, I've been very much alone in all aspects of my life ever since migration, ever since I left my wonderful culture in Africa. I've been very much, as one might say, a fish out of water, but that's okay. Because it's taught me a lot. It's taught me how to be a thinker, and it's taught me how to see through things and to see through situations very, very accurately. As it happens, I'm competing with a rooster, as one does. So I feel that it's been a hell of an experience, but you can see by the way I speak, you can see by my face, my facial features, that I have a very good equilibrium. I'm very much in control of my sensations and my emotions. You can see it. People who say they can't see that sort of thing, I think they just are either lying to themselves or they are rather undeveloped. My background culture, which as I said is in Southern Africa, was a culture, I say was, because thanks to the liberals it's basically annihilated, at least in people's minds, and it's really not so functioning anymore. Not so much, thanks to the Western liberals and their ideology and their cruel agenda. And believe me, liberals can be cruel. Believe me, they can be. So, especially when they have an agenda that they feel is very syrupy sweet and they will pursue at all costs, like bears to honey. They can be cruel. Anyway, I don't mean to say that they're bears either. They're more like little rascals, little yogi bears, little cuddly bears, but with very big bellies. That's what I really meant. Anyway, they can be cruel. They can be really nasty when they have an agenda. They can be. So my culture is fundamentally dead, but if I can relate to you a little about my culture that I have still in me, it'll be really similar to the generation of your grandparents, probably, to the World War II generation, that is to say, to the traditionalists. It would be very similar to that. And the main feature of it is that one is not looking always at oneself and estimating how one relates to things in a very personal way, but one is looking at the world as if it were directly, without a lens of subjective personality, but just looking, just enjoying, just being. And it's a much more simple approach to things. Also more stoic, much more stoic. So two things, more simple and more stoic, because this way of looking at things, it doesn't take one's person into very much consideration at all. My communication style is, I can see this, I can see that, I can see the other. But what is confusing to the personality of the style is when someone says, oh, it must mean you see it like that because you are, fill in the space, fill in the dots, you are, you see it that way because you are arrogant, you are thinking that you are so clever, you are, and it just literally, quite simply, it doesn't compute with me. It makes no sense that I see something in a way because I am something. I've tried working it from that angle. I've tried it a lot, and it still makes no sense to me. That is a very modern way of looking at things. How I am, what right do I have to express that based on how I am? The old style personality, which is in me, which I have, is much simpler than that. It's just, this is what I see, this is what I observe, this is what I notice. And it's really a delight to be that way. It's really It's really free from a lot of burdens until these modern geezers get on your case. Until then, it's a delight. It's pure enjoyment of pure reality without the filters.